Hello everyone, and welcome to Morning Coffee Break. Got my coffee. How's everybody doing this morning? I got about 7 hours of sleep again. I went to bed at 12. I have to wait until I'm just absolutely falling asleep before I even try to go to bed. I can't go to sleep if I'm semi-awake. I have to be just falling over asleep. Let me get this a little bit closer to me. There we go. I was saying on my devotions, we were supposed to take the bandages off yesterday. They said not to. You shouldn't have to clean it unless it's bleeding excessively. They said just leave it alone. You know, don't clean on it or anything, or put any antibiotic or anything. And that's what they said, but. You know, it looked surprisingly good, but we were both shocked that it was like about 7 inches long, the incision. We thought, you know, with the laparoscopic, it leaves one that they can about put like a Band-Aid on. So we thought maybe this one would be, a couple inches bigger. But it has 12 staples in it, and Joy had been told that something about Steri-Strips. And I wondered how it would stay together good with Steri-Strips anyway, no matter how big it or small it was. But no, it's got staples, 12 of them, so it looks good though. There's very minimal bleeding, and it should do fine as far as the healing of the incision. And I'm still sore, but not as bad as even yesterday. Each day seems a little bit better. I still have my normal pain, you know, from the other hernias and fistula and things. But this hernia that they fixed was the worst of all four. And once it gets to feeling, you know, once it's healed, I'm sure that's going to help me some. I mean, to be able to get around better too and things, because I couldn't be upright more than 5 minutes while I had the other one, and it still bothers me with some of the other ones because they're out, you know, when you're upright, and it would start to strangulate the intestines that were out. It would start to strangulate it, and when it does that, it starts to hurt and burn really bad. I mean, to the point where you just can't, you have to sit down or lie down. You have to just about, I mean, or you'd end up in the hospital because it will damage your intestines that way. They can die, actually. The area that, you know, it gets pinched. The other ones, there's one of them that's almost as big as that one was, on the same side but up further towards my chest, and it does somewhat the same thing, but it takes a little bit longer before it happens with it. The last two are not as big as that one, so they won't be as big of a problem, I don't think. I don't know if I mentioned it in this one or in the devotions, but we got a little rain last night late. It rained for maybe 20 minutes or so. thunder and stuff. Then it just went away. So some parts of the garden got some rain better that way. But this heat, it's using a lot of water, you know, to keep this garden going. Our yard looks brown. I hope this little rain helped the yard some. But it's brown looking. Back here is not as bad as the front part. I don't know if y'all can see or tell anything about it from here. Oh, no wonder I've got to turn that way. I don't know if you can tell, but it is like a light brownish almost. I'd say that's the first rain we've had in the yard. Or, you know, first rain. It's probably been about 3 weeks. Oh, I was looking to see if Kitty was up there, but she's not. I'll show you the sky. There's some of the birds up there. They look like doves. Just waiting on me. Feet are still pretty full. But the sky is a little bit overcast. As you can tell, you can see the sun shining through those trees by now. Up early this morning with my usual pains, not just the pain from this. About 7. Laid there for a little bit. It's amazing what some more like uninterrupted sleep can do for you as far as how you feel when you get up the next day. Sometimes I have to get up 5 or 6 times in one night for various things. Overnight, but last night I just got up 1 time. After I went to bed, so I got 2 different times of maybe 3.5 hours each of uninterrupted sleep. Because if you never go into a deep sleep, you may as well have not got any sleep, really. What do they call it? The REM? Rapid eye movement or something like that is it, when you're having that, that's the type of sleep that helps you. I think I'm not really up on all that, but I think that's what it is. I don't have many. It seems like I can't remember my dreams hardly anymore. When I was more stressed out, when I was working and, when I was able to work before all this happened to me, I would dream dreams about work. Every night, my dream would be about either where I was working right then or a place that I had worked before. If For years, I had the same type dream almost every night of when I was working at Coca-Cola, and it was driving me crazy. I mean, I couldn't do anything about it, you know, and it bothered me. It wasn't a scary dream, it just that it was the same thing over and over, you know, pretty much. So I don't know when exactly it was, but finally it went away. I think I was still doing it up until I couldn't work anymore. Or actually, at first, the company I was working for just up and closed all of a sudden, gave us like 3 days notice. But I was still having them then. And it'd probably been almost about 20 years since I'd worked there. And after they closed down, then I lost my job. Then, you know, I ended up having more of my colon taken out because it got perforated again, I guess from all the worry, and my Crohn's disease, which was in remission, it had come out of remission to do all that. And I ended up having more taken out then, but it seems like at that point on is when I stopped having the dreams. And it you know, like I said, I felt better because I didn't have them anymore. Mentally, I mean. Hope everybody's having a good Sunday. Ooh, there went the hummingbird, but it didn't stop. Huh. The hummingbirds seem more scared of other birds than they are of us. Here comes some starlings. Ooh, they took off. Better that way. I bet that ceramic one doesn't have much in it right now because we hadn't looked at it yet. But the other one's about full, so they'll be fine. There's plenty on the ground probably still too. Hi everyone. Want some breakfast? Don't fight. Female starling is obviously the one that's not as dark. The male, I think, is the darker one, and the female is like a charcoal color. Listen to her. Like a chuckle. I'm probably not going to be able to use my telescope for a while. I have to be too attentive to it. I have to, you know, check on it periodically and make sure it's not just showing nothing. Here's a blue jay over here, but if I try to move the camera, it'll fly off. Well, it already did. Nice looking blue jay. Yeah, so, you know, I probably just won't be able to do them until I'm better. You can still hear a lot of the insects that you hear at night. Boy, it's loud out here at night with the sounds. It's a relaxing like sound though. I did one video out here at night. Show everybody what it sounded like. I may do another one soon. If y'all think you'd like it. I'm always up for suggestions. I may not, you know, do whatever it is, but I've got some great suggestions in the past for things that I'm still doing now, probably. Suggestions from my viewers. Well, a dove. Hello there. Oh. Hope everybody has a great day today. What are y'all having for dinner? I didn't set anything out, but I'll tell you what, those ribs we had last night that we got down here at Grocery Outlet. Oh, goodness. They were delicious with that Stubbs barbecue sauce. I fixed them in the crock pot, and I put garlic Mrs. Dash and some garlic powder on them. We love garlic. But I didn't overdo it with that because the Stubbs sauce is awesome. You really don't need anything with it at all. Yeah, I fixed those in the crock pot. They just fell right off the bone. Didn't have to worry about gnawing on them or nothing. They're just as tender as it could be. Delicious. And we had some mashed potatoes and tomatoes from the garden. I was trying to think if we had anything else. Oh, bread. We had some hot dog buns left over, and you know, when you get a pack of hot dogs and you only use five, you have like three left. Half the time, nothing ever happens with them three, so we joy fixed them in the oven with some butter and garlic. They're real good that way, too. Like a little mini thing of garlic bread, you know. I don't know if y'all can see or not, but the weeds is already starting down there where they just cleared this off. I don't know if y'all can see this. If you look right past the, like towards the rock and then on back where they cut all that down, you can, might see that stuff growing already. It'll be right back like it was in several years. That's pitiful though, because I used to go down there and spray all the time. It worries me. I sprayed so much that I might have got the, I know I got some fumes if the wind changes or something, you know. Plus I used to spray at work around the property a lot. But that's almost all not mine anyway. I cut it back and sprayed everything. I can't do that now. It's a shame though. So tonight, I don't know what we're going to have really. Probably just something from the freezer. I've still got a whole case of those taquitos that I bought down here at Grocery Outlet that are really good. We hadn't had them for about a week or so, so might have them with some sour cream on them. And got so much packs of taco sauce from Taco Bell. They give you two handfuls every time you ask for some. You don't need to buy taco sauce at the store. I put some of that on it. It's really good that way. So if we don't feel like that, there's other choices. We just had pizza the other night, so I don't know about that, but we've got some fish in there. We've got some coconut butterfly shrimp from Aldi. They're the crispy fish fillets too from Aldi. And we've got some regular breaded butterfly shrimp, but I have to be in the mood, or we do, for seafood. We don't eat as much as we should, but I have to pretty much, or like I said, all of us have to agree we want it. It's really good though. But we've got some other things in there too. I'd have to look. Don't feel like cooking much if it gets hot again. But the crock pot kept it from getting so hot in there yesterday, because I had it on low. Oh. Yeah. See some radishes we need to get. The carrots are doing. I had some roasted vegetables. If I can see any carrots that are done. Well, that zucchini was the best I've ever had that we had this year. I probably got about 14 of them off that plant. Well, I hope everybody has a great day. I'm going to go in and catch up on my comments and stuff and just relax and have some breakfast later on. So everybody, please press that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell so that you get all my videos as soon as they come out. Have a great day, everyone. I don't know what I'll get into after this today. We'll just have to see. Bye-bye.